guys, I'm Sammy and welcome back to the Soul Brothers channel, and this is my first impressions look on the Anta RR6 or the Rajon Rondo 6. So this shoe is going for $110. Rajon Rondo, I don't think, is signed with Anta anymore. I mean, if you look at, you know, what shoes he was wearing during the finals, he was wearing like the Kobe 5 Protro and like the PG4s during the season. I don't really even think he wore this shoe all that much. So I don't really know what's going on there, but as you guys know, Anta kills it with bringing you guys quality, very good materials, very good cushion tech with a very good price tag, right? So if you guys do want to cop, I'll leave a link in the description box, but let's get it started right off with the Tracciones. So for the pattern, they're using a herringbone traction pattern, like in these pods. There's two pods, one in the forefoot, one in the heel. In this colorway, the pods are a different color than the rest of the outsole, but it doesn't feel like it's a different density. So I don't think they're using a dual density outsole. The rubber is very, very hard, you know, especially where the herringbone is. And I feel like this is going to be very durable. Of course, I'm gonna be testing these outdoors. The bite seems pretty good. You know, I tried on my wood floors and seemed pretty good. It didn't seem to have like a crazy good bite or anything, but of course, we'll have to see on that. As far as the heel to toe transition goes, it's pretty smooth. You know, you have a nice curved shape here in the heel. It doesn't feel clunky or anything, and you have a good amount of heel compression, which we'll get into. Here in the forefoot, you have a nice curved shape as well, you know, so you get a nice rocking motion there, and you have a little bit of forefoot flex. So as you guys can see here in the midfoot, there is a carbon fiber midfoot chain plate. I don't know how far into the forefoot it goes, but I'm guessing it goes pretty far because like it only bends at this part of the forefoot, you know, like at the tip of the forefoot, and that's not how the foot works, you know, like where the ball of your foot is, it starts pretty much right here. So you want it to start bending right here, but it starts bending a little bit like closer to the toe. But anyways, you know, so there is a little bit of flex, but overall it feels pretty stiff. And I feel like this carbon fiber plate makes the shoe feel overall very stiff. It feels very similar to like the APO Concept X, which also has a full length carbon fiber plate. But of course, it's not horrible because of the shape. The shape kind of makes up for it with this rocking motion here in the heel and in the forefoot. All right, moving on to the cushioning setup. They're using a full length A Flash Foam midsole, and it's super nice, right? So here in the heel, it's very, very thick. A Flash Foam is nice. You know, they use it in the KT4, the KT5, not in the 6, unfortunately, right? So it is a higher density foam. It's not a super light foam, but it's soft. It has a nice little bounce as well. And here in the heel, it's very, very comfortable, right? So there is a lot of compression. It has a nice little rebound back as well. Not as much as React. And of course, not as bouncy as Zoom, but it has a nice rebound back. I would say it has a nice little blend of bounce and like compression, you know, like that soft feeling here in the heel. Here in the forefoot, it's a little bit more dead. And of course, you have a little bit of an offset, right? So here in the heel, it feels a little bit high, and then in the forefoot, it's a little bit lower to the ground. So I feel like impact protection is going to be really, really good, especially for heel strikes. And the overall cushioning setup, like this A Flash Foam, is very, very comfortable. I like it. The only thing I don't like about it is the shape of the midsole. Like if you guys see, look at how bulky and bulged out the cushion is, right? It reminds me of like, I don't know, old school Adidas shoes where it's like super bulky and very bubbly, you know? But anyways, the overall cushioning feels very nice, and the insole is very nice as well. Yeah, I don't know what they did here, but it's a nice thick insole. I'm guessing it's a polyurethane material, and you know, improve the stepping comfort. And also another interesting thing is that if you feel the insole, like if you look at it though, it looks like one of those stiff strobo boards that Adidas uses. It looks like it's very glued down and looks very stiff, right? But then if you poke at it with your finger, it actually compresses and you can feel the A Flash Foam, you know? So the stepping comfort and the cushion right underneath your foot feels very, very nice. I'm very surprised about that. So I really like the cushioning setup so far. All right, as far as the materials go, they're using a full on knit upper throughout this entire upper, basically throughout this entire upper, right? So here in the toe box, it's a very, very thin material. It is glued down though. Like if you look underneath this material, you can see all the underlying material that they had to glue to this knit upper, of course. So it does feel a little stiff stiff, or I guess not stiff, but like a little flimsy, you know? But of course, for knit material, you either have to do that and, you know, keep it thin or make the knit super thick like the LeBron 18 and not have all of that glue. And also another thing that they did, which I haven't seen since the Kobe 11, is they used TPU strands inside the actual knit, which is really, really cool. So if you look closely at the Kobe 11, the TPU strands go perpendicular to the shoe, right? So of course, in basketball, you do a lot of lateral movements. So obviously you want the TPU strands going this way. But here in the Rajon Rondo 6, they're going parallel to the shoe. So how is that gonna help for support? You know, I don't really understand that, but I guess it's cool. And the TPU strands definitely look a lot like thinner than the Kobe 11 was. But I guess it's cool that they added that. And also another thing is it's only here in the toe box area. Like, it's not visible here on the lateral side. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, wouldn't you want support here instead of like here in the toe box? I don't really understand the design, but I guess you do have these two thicker lines here. And of course there is more stitching here. So I guess that does add for like support and all that. But yeah, I mean, the overall material feels super nice. You know, it conforms to your foot very well, very minimal. It's soft, it's comfortable and all that. It is a one booty upper, you know, and then have like a shroud with this knit material that kind of goes over that, right? So it's dual layered basically. And the tongue is made of a neoprene material and it's stretchy. And then once you put on the shoe, it stretches over your foot, especially here in the midfoot area, and it feels awesome. I really, really like how that feels. One thing that I don't like about it though is it's like ankle color. So if you look at it, it's very thin, which I guess is good, but they're using like a fuse or like a plastic material, and it kind of digs into my ankle and like my ankle area. It's not to the point where it's like it hurts, but it's just a little uncomfortable, and I feel like they should have just kept it a knit material, but you know, that's okay. And of course you have a full-on pull tab, and then of course the tongue extends up a lot. So just open it up, just put your foot in like a slipper and you're good to go. And then here in the heel, you have very, very nice Achilles pillows, right? So it's made of a very nice soft material, like the neoprene material. It uses like a gel foam as well. And there's really no foam at all in this shoe. Like there's no foam actually. Like if you look inside the shoe, there's no padding or foam, which is interesting. So the upper is just super minimal. The only padding that there is are these Achilles pillows. So I like that. As far as the lacing system goes, they're using a fused material and it looks like a rectangular box. I don't like it all too much because it makes the shoe really hard to like lace up. So when you're trying to pull on the laces, it like gets stuck, you know? So I guess it's good as far as like, once you pull it, it stays, you know what I'm saying? But actually pulling it is kind of annoying. So I'm sure that'll break in though. That'll probably get easier, but I don't really like it right now. But the overall materials for 110 bucks is awesome. You know, if I remember correctly, the Kobe's were like 200 bucks and they were like, they were using TPU strands. Dude, it's literally plastic, you know what I'm saying? But anyways, yeah, so I really like the materials. And of course here in the heel, we have an external TPU heel counter, but it's like a really soft rubberized plastic and it's a very thin plastic, so I don't really think it adds all too much for support, but there is an internal TPU heel counter. All right, moving on to the fit is okay for me. Like the RR5 fit was really, really nice, but here in the 6 they made it a little bit roomier and they made it a little bit long as well. So I did go true to size and there is a little bit of length here, so I would suggest going down half the size. And width wise I would say it's around normal, you know, it's not super snug, so maybe even a little wide. And then here in the toe box area, it's slightly snug. There is a little bit of dead space here in the toe box. I mean, it's not to the point where it's super uncomfortable and I hate the fit because of it, but I wish it was a little bit more snug, you know what I'm saying? And I actually don't know if this material is going to stretch out because of the TPU strands, which is a good thing. I don't want it to be any roomier, but we'll have to see on that. The Kobe 11 didn't stretch out all too much either, so I do have hopes for that. And then here in the midfoot as well. I mean, I actually like to fit in the midfoot because of this neoprene like material and this one boot construction. It kind of like stretches over your foot and it feels great. So the fit for me, I don't really like all too much. Maybe if I went down half a size, it would be a little bit better. All right, moving on to the support. Support, I feel like it's going to be really, really good. So if you guys look at the outrigger, look at that. Look at how much it's crazy. It I would say it comes out maybe like an inch and a half as far as the outrigger goes. It's a very low and wide base, so I feel like lateral stability is going to be really, really good. And as far as the lateral containment goes, I feel like it's going to be really good as well, right? So if you look at here in the heel, I mean, you don't even need a heel counter or anything here. Like, if you look at the cushioning, like, it comes up like crazy and it bulges out, which I don't like. But of course, it comes up here in the heel acting as a counter. And then here in the forefoot, the foam comes up as well. And the material is pretty like supportive, you know, it doesn't stretch at all or anything. So I feel like lateral containment is going to be really, really good. Moving on to the weight, I don't know, guys. I mean, like I said, the upper feels super minimal. There's really no padding or anything. But as you guys know, A-Flash foam is a pretty high density foam. So it's probably gonna be kind of heavy, I feel like. Maybe, yeah, oh, okay. So 13.8 ounces. And then for the right pair, it's 13.4 ounces, right? So that's pretty heavy, you know. Like, of course, you know, for this knit material and how minimal the upper feels, it does feel a little heavy. It definitely feels very bottom heavy though, you know, which I don't know. I don't really like to feel that all too much in my ball shoes, but it's not a huge deal. You know, if you've ever worn Vans or like, I guess, Converse, that's what it feels like. Personally for me, I don't think weight is gonna be a huge issue though, because like I said, the upper feels very minimal and all that weight is pretty much coming from the bottom of the shoe. All right, as far as the aesthetics go, I really like how this shoe looks. I feel like I like the 5 a little bit better, but I mean, Anta's been killing it. You know, I like the knit design. I like the carbon fiber touch as well, and it's only 110 bucks. Like, they're adding a carbon fiber plate and the shoe is only 110 bucks. That's crazy, right? But yeah, I like the aesthetics. Tell us what you guys think of the aesthetics down in the comment section below. So for 110 bucks, I don't know. There are some things I don't like about the shoe all too much. I mean, it's not like I hate it right now. Like I said, the fit isn't the best. The cushion feels awesome, but it feels a little bulky here in the heel and it is pretty bottom heavy. But there are a lot of good things about the shoe so far that I like, you know, like the materials, how minimal the upper feels, the cushion feels very nice, the traction seems very durable, and if it does have a good stop, that's good as well. So I don't know, it's a little bit of a toss-up right now, but overall, I guess I do like it. I do like how it looks, and it's only 110 bucks, like I keep saying. So if you guys do want to cop, I'll leave a link in the description box, but that is my first impressions look on the RR6. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.